Yeah, and welcome to this plumberparts.co.uk video. Today I'm going to tell you about balancing heating systems, why you should do it, the symptoms that mean you might have to do it, and how to do it. Firstly, let's have a look at the general layout of a heating system. We'll have a look at it schematically because that will help you understand why balancing a heating system is so important. Let's say we have two stories, level one and ground. We have the boiler at the bottom. Coming out of the boiler, we have a pump that goes up through a diverter valve, through some radiators upstairs, and then downstairs with common returns going back to the boiler. Okay, so we've got radiators here. The first reason that heating systems should be balanced is even if there's a pump on a heating system, hot water naturally likes to gravitate up and stay upstairs and then make its quick route back to the boiler. So what you often find is the radiators upstairs are getting loads of heat and the ones downstairs are still really quite cool. So what you should do is go to the lock shield on the radiators upstairs, close them and then open them about a quarter of a turn. You won't notice any difference in the radiator's heat capacity or not, but you will notice that more hot water flow is diverted to the radiators downstairs. Now you go downstairs, make sure those radiators are open, and that means the heating system should be balanced. Another reason you should balance a heating system is say this radiator's getting hot, that one's getting hot, and this one's getting hot. The last radiator on the line isn't getting so hot, and that's because these three radiators are effectively pinching all the hot water flow delivered by the boiler and the pump. What you do then is remove the lock shields on these radiators here, strangle those two up there down, shut them, give them a quarter of a turn. This one here, bring that down, okay, and shut them and give them a quarter of a turn. We also do a video on why one radiator isn't getting hot, because it can be more than one reason, not just the fact that the system isn't balanced. But that is a brief idea of how you balance a system and why. Now let's take a quick look at the lock shield, how to shut it, and also give it that quarter of a turn nip to make sure that it's all balanced. So, here we are upstairs, okay? Now the radiator's up here getting really hot, so let's have a look at how we're going to strangle this one down and balance this system. So here we are with our first upstairs radiator. There's four on this system upstairs, and do the same thing to each one. Here's the lock shield end, not the TRV end. Pop the lock shield cap off and close it by turning it anti-clockwise. Once it's fully closed, just slack it back a quarter of a turn. Do that to each radiator upstairs and you should find then that the radiator side of the heating system is balanced. Now let's have a look at what you can do to balance out the hot water coil on your heating cylinder if you have an indirect one. Right, so we've had a look at how to balance the radiators on the heating system. Now we're going to have a look at how to balance the hot water coil on the indirect cylinder. A lot of houses in the UK have indirect hot water coils on the cylinder. That means hot water from the boiler is passed through a coil in the cylinder and that heats the water up. Now often these coils are 22mm in pipe size and when the valve opens up to let hot water through that coil, it pinches loads of heat from the radiators. Therefore the indirect hot water coil should also be balanced and regulated. Most plumbers when installing an indirect hot water cylinder will put a flow regulating valve on the return side of the coil. Let's have a look at it. So you have your boiler, your pump and your three port valve, or if you've got an S plan it will just be a two port valve for each side. You have all your radiators with their flows and returns. We have the flow coming up here from the boiler, goes through the valve, into our hot water coil in our cylinder and then back out. And it is here that we fit the flow regulating valve on the return side of the hot water coil. That will go back into the return side of the boiler. So to recap, we have the boiler, the pump and our diverter valves. The radiators upstairs have been strangled down and regulated, and the ones downstairs are getting a good flow of hot water. We've also strangled down the return on the indirect hot water cylinder, and the whole heating system now is working properly. Remember, balancing a heating system out, all you need to do is give each component in the heating system an equal amount of flow so the heating system heats up equally. If you want any more information, visit our website at plumberparts.co.uk and remember, subscribe to our videos on YouTube. I hope you found this video helpful. If you think we've missed anything out or you want to ask us any questions, just comment on this video and we'll do our best. Thanks very much. See you soon, guys. Plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and...